TikTok and be like him. How do you walk, think, dress, and talk here? When you look in the mirror, who do you see? What is your image? Reflection. What words do you use to speak here? As you walk, think, talk, be like him. As his faithful disciple, child of our Heavenly Father. Think wisely and do the right things here. Let him guide, protect, shield you through and from them, the trials and tribulations here. Lean on and put your total trust in him. Be faithful to him. Love, serve, follow him. And his love, peace, joy, and light will truthfully live in and shine in you. Then, you will make it to our eternal home and live forever with him and his kingdom. At the end, between heaven, living eternally with him, or dying and suffering. At the end. By loving, serving, and following him here and being faithful to him, you will end in his kingdom and live forever, where there is love, peace, joy, and light, where truth will live in around you forever. And you will live in total peace. And you will truthfully live in total peace. Amen. Amen.
Truthfully live worship Him. So ask yourself, who or what? Who or what do you think about from the second you get up to the second you go to bed? It's truthfully and honestly who and what you bow down to, serve, idolize, and worship here. He knows. You cannot lie or hide the truth or from Him. It's impossible. He's everywhere spiritually. Everywhere. Amen. And it's written in His book, and where are you going to add whether your name is in the book of life or not?
Thanks so much for your support.
This is the written account of Adam's moment.
Here's my
when God created man, open ears and listen. God created man. He made him in the likeness of God. He created them male and female. And blessed them. And they were created, He called them man. When Adam had lived 130 years, he had a son. In his own likeness, in his own image, and he named him Seth. After Seth was born, Adam lived 800 years and had a son and daughters, although Adam lived 930 years and then he died. When Seth had lived 105 years, he became the father of Enosh. And after he became the father of Enosh, Seth lived 807 years and had other sons and daughters. Although Seth lived 912 years, and after he became the father. They would not listen to the judges, but prostitute themselves to other gods and worship them.
There's Michael W. Smith with a new hallelujah.
So if you prostitute yourself to other gods and worship them, here, he knows.
Are you just trying your best every day?
And that's where you're going to end on this eternal judgment day between heaven.
I want to encourage you with some words from author Elizabeth George. She says, everyone's life is stained with sin. You're not alone in your struggle to live a godly life. God loves you. He cares for you. You can count on and enjoy the promise and reality of his forgiveness. Forgiveness. Just the sound of that word can bring joy to the heart. In Jeremiah 31, verse 4, God says, I will forgive their iniquity. In fact, the verse also says that God will remember our sin no more.
I remember Psalm 24, the earth
now,
is the Lord's.
Don't stew the over earth the situation the and what happened.
And everything in it, keep the world and all who live in it.
Doubting God's mercy. And that robs you of spiritual progress. Acknowledge your sin before God.
God is our refuge and strength and ever present, help in trouble. Just lean
and
put your trust in
him.
He will guide us and protect and shoot us through from them. So at the end, we can make it to our eternal home.
Hi, this is Dave Brooks, WCIC station manager.
Amen.
Recently, the words to this song hit me in a fresh, powerful way. Each simple, small act of love expresses God's heart to a hope-starved world. Whether it's a team in China playing with orphan children, a lunch buddy with a grade school student, or several hundred volunteers treating single moms to an unforgettable day through Single Moms Morning Out, we're so thrilled to see people from all parts of the WCIC community become those doors in this world for God's love to walk through. I hope we'll hear from you during our fall fundraiser vision starting October 7th. Our need is for $230,000, and we can reach this together with 640 families joining Team 360, giving $30 a month in ongoing support.
Would you stand before me? My heart would not go out to these people. Send them away from my presence. Let them go.
Thanks for talking
and if
over
they
with you.
Say,
and for getting
where
involved
shall
in
we
vision.
Go? Tell them this is what the Lord says.
WCIC.
Those destined for death to death. Those for the sword, those for starvation.
WCIC Keegan Peoria. 98.9 W255
AI Wilmington.
100.5 W263 AO Galesburg.
I will
and
send
on your
four
smartphone
kinds of
to the WCIC app.
The sword to kill, the dogs to drag away, and the birds of the air and the beasts of the earth to devour. The sword to kill, the dogs to drag away, and the birds of the air and the beasts of the earth to devour and destroy.
New Life Media.
I will make them abhorrent to all the kingdoms of the earth because of what Meshaniah, son of
Zechariah,
king of Judah,
who
will have pity on you, O Jerusalem? Who will mourn for you? Who will stop to ask how you are? You have rejected me, and declares the Lord. You have rejected me, and declares the Lord. You keep on backsliding. You keep on backsliding. So I will lay hands on you and destroy you. I can no longer show compassion. I will winnow them with a winnowing fork in the city gates of the land. I will bring betterment and destruction on my people. For they have not charged their ways, changed their ways. I will make their widows at midday, I will bring a destroyer against the mothers of their young men. Suddenly, I will bring them on them anguish and tear. I will bring on them anguish and tear. The mother of seven will grow faint and breath for last. Her son will say, well, it is your day. She will be disgraced and humiliated. I put the survivors to the sword before their enemies. Surely I will deliver you for a good purpose. Surely I will make your enemies. a fortified wall of bronze. They will fight against you, but will not overcome you. For I am with you. For I am with you to rescue and save you. I will save you from the hands of the wicked and redeem you from the grasp of the poor.
WCIC's Call to Worship. Hi, it's Janine, a little past 11. Thanks for letting me join you today. And I pray that the music of Call to Worship can just help prepare your heart and your mind for your worship experience today. Here's Brian Dirksen now with Refiner's Fire.
To win two diamond necklaces from Bremer Jewelry. And I'm so excited to talk to you about our third winner, Deanna from Cleveland. She was
so thrilled
to win these necklaces.
For the day of the Lord is near. For the day of the Lord is near.
She gets to keep for herself, but even more excited
in the valley of decision. In the valley of decision.
decision. That's on to her daughter, who is
the sun and moon will be darkened, so and the stars no longer shine. The Lord will roar from Zion, and the thunder from Jerusalem. The earth and the sky will tremble.
Make your pledge before them.
For the Lord will be a refuge for his people,
the strongholds for the people of Israel. So thanks for joining.
Then you will know that I am the Lord your God, dwelling in Zion, and Zion my holy hill. Jerusalem will be holy, holy. Never again will foreigners invade her. In that day, the mountains will drip new wine, and the hills will flow with milk. And all the ravens of judgment will run water, a fountain will flow from the Lord's house, and will water in the valley as Sirius. But Egypt will be desolate, Edom a desolate waste, because of violence done to the people of Judah, in whose land they shed innocent blood. Judah will be inhabited forever, and Jerusalem through all generations. There are blood guilt which I have not pardoned. The Lord dwells in Zion. The Lord dwells in Zion. Amen. Now I'm starting to sprinkle, so I'm going to make this fast.
Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher.
The love of the Heavenly Father is not in you. everything in this world, the cravings of sinful man, the lust of his eyes and the boasting what he has and does not come from the Heavenly Father, but from the world. The world and its desires pass away. In other words, the world will die in the midst of hell. But the man who does the will of God lives forever.
Right.
Okay, rebuild for tornado victims in Washington, Illinois, volunteers. Their number is 309-573-2670.